Welcome to r/maliciouscompliance, where we share stories of people conforming to the letter, but not the spirit of a request. And today we have three great stories. So subscribe, hit the like button, and let's begin. The first story. Company policies essentially are a form of malicious compliance. In turn, I abide with complete compliance and return the hassle with monetary penalties. The second story. Lady thinks I shorted her on her business card order. Requests that I count them in front of her. The third story. Kid wants to hand in his application to a manager in person, while the restaurant is very busy. The first story is, no appointment, no problem. I'm essentially a courier, but for large volume of smaller items, or larger items that won't fit conveniently on a FedEx-type truck. The company I work for consolidated shipments at locations, groups them into large shipments, which I deliver to the end delivery point. It's a value-add rush type of service that conforms to track supply chains for medical and aerospace industries, our bread and butter. We operate on some expensive tariffs and contracts, all agreed to before we carry anything on board. So I'll drive 500 or so kilometers per day and visit 10 to 15 places, either delivering or picking up stuff to move. I generally visit the same places almost every day. You get to know the guys and ladies on the docks and they won't delay you. You don't delay them. I'm also paid by the hour with OT, so while longer days aren't a deterrent, I do try to maintain some work-life balance. Last spring, I get a newer customer added on my route that was going to make things kinda tight in the day, both in distance and time. However, the stuff they ordered regularly was hazardous material that only left me and another driver legally able to carry it. However, the product struggles paled in comparison to the huge pain in the A this customer was to me, right from the start. Now, I have thick skin. You just have to let some SH slide, but if you screw around with my earnings, I'll cut you. Unlike all my other stops, which typically are small warehouses or retail sites, this was an industrial plant in a rather large compound. I'd Google mapped it before, so I knew what I was getting into, but from day one I was letting the boss know how much this was going to impact my route. So first shipment day came, and I planned on visiting this place in the middle of my route for the day. So there's a few trucks ahead of me, and after 15 minutes of waiting, I arrive at the outer security gate. Me. Hi, I'm here with three skids of product for XYZ company. Security. What's your appointment number? Me. I don't have an appointment. Security. I can't let you in without an appointment. Who you here for? Me. XYZ company. I'm basically a courier. I never work with appointments. Security. You need an appointment. Everyone has one. Relents and calls some shipper person who I guess vouches for me. Yeah. Get told where to go and plant. Security. Now I need you to put on the PPE the site requires. Hard hat, reflective vest, eye protection, safety boots, long sleeve shirt and pants, ear protection and gloves. Me. Holy F. I had it all, but who drives in all that SH? All that for a few minutes? Security. I can't let you on site without the required PPE. Now sign this lengthy form with all the site rules. Security. I'll need ID to sign you in. Me. I hand over company ID. Security. I need second ID since this is your first visit. Me. I hand over my TWIC. Security. This photo doesn't look like you. Me. No kidding. I have a beard now. I haven't seen my chin in years. Security. Okay, you're registered now. Drive over to gate D and they'll let you into the loading area. Finally, almost 30 minutes passed from the time I pulled up. I'm in the inner sanctum of this plant. Get unloaded and make my way to the same guardhouse to exit. Time for round two. Security. Is the trailer sealed? Me. No. Security. Why not? Me. I was dropping off your product. Now I have other deliveries to make. Security offers some suggestions to speed up. Blah blah, wear your PPE, have an appointment number. So all told, it took almost 90 minutes to visit a place that would normally take 15 for me to unload. I call the boss as I'm leaving to let him know how hard this is going to impact the routes. Stuff's going to have to shift around if this is a regular occurrence. Boss asks me if I log the time spent. Of course. Well then let's bill for the delay. 4x15-minute blocks at $60 per. $240 added to the rate charged. That should get noticed. Our tariffs give 30 minutes free per stop. Afterwards, it's charged per 15 minutes. Tariffs agreed to by all parties before we carry anything. So the above repeats itself a few times over the next few months. I know the routine well after the first, but it's still taking almost 90 minutes to get done, and each time I'm billing my delay time dutifully, while following the site's rules to the letter. After several months, I get to my unload point, and there's a white hat. White hard hats are usually management or other non-labor staff. There I don't recognize. He asks me about all the detention pay I'm putting on the bill. I inform him how I'm an LTL driver, and our delays start after 30 minutes, and I'll spend that often waiting in line to get in. I explained that even today I'll be spending at least 1 hour of detention, depending on how long it takes to get out. Him, that can't be right. He holds my paperwork hostage for almost another 30 minutes, until returning in a huff with another sheepish-looking white hat. Him, show me where we agreed to this. We're your customer. You should be working to keep us happy. Me, I'm sorry, but that's between you and the business office. I can provide my boss's phone number so you can discuss this further, but I really need to be leaving. I have many other stops today. Finally, I'm out again, this time billing 90 minutes of wait time, $360. Explain to the boss man what went down and how the jig is up. Monetary penalties have been noticed. Boss told me later in the day how this angry VP tore me up for being generally unprofessional, not addressing his concerns, and dragging my heels making the detention claims higher. My boss stood up for me, explaining I complied with all site rules, never broke speed limit, 5 miles per hour, but site security and check-in policies were the contributing factor to each detention request. In a huff, the VP canceled all deliveries until further notice. Well, this was Christmas for my boss. Now we can just store the products that are still arriving, at hazmat storage rates to boot. Few more weeks pass. Oh, I'm going back to XYZ company? Boss. Yeah, but notice the address? Me. Oh, they moved? Next door. Boss. Yep, deliver it to the outside warehouse. They'll move it in. Take this email with you. Best you don't even have to check in. Just drive up to the exit ramp. They'll just let you in like they do FedEx, UPS, Canada Post. So I happily roll up to the exit gate, get out, see the same lovely security people explain why I'm here. Email in hand, they succumb to reason, with minimal delay to let me in. 15 minutes later, I'm merrily on my way back in schedule, getting home at my regular times. I let the boss know it seems resolved, and it remains so until the end of our contract with them. The next story is, you want exactly 500 business cards? Well, okay. So, I work at a print shop within a national office retailer. You know the one. One of our most popular products is our business cards, because they're ridiculously cheap, for a large amount, and you can order and pick up same day. The only issue is, they're a complete pain in my A to make, for several reasons. First reason, it's pretty hard to align our template and the printer, so that both sides print correctly. Second reason is because our business card cutter occasionally decides to throw a hissy fit and cut things at an angle. Of course, corporate won't spring for a new cutter or a properly aligned printer, but I've managed to tame the beast pretty well. Now, the cutter only cuts sideways cards every 7-8 pages or so. It's not much of a loss for us if it means we get straight business cards. Anyways, this is all set up to say that due to the cutter problems, I always print extra pages with my orders. It's not an exact science, and I'm overly cautious, so really often customers will get 10 to 20 more cards than they ordered, especially in larger orders. It's win-win. However, the special boxes we put our business cards in are very slightly bigger than the amount they should actually hold. Not sure why that is, but our 500 card boxes actually hold around 560 cards. I've checked, meaning that there's about a quarter to a half inch of room in the box. Be assured though, I've never shorted a customer on cards. Today, a very picky and A lady, henceforth AL, came in for her 500 prepaid business cards. I showed her a single card, and she was delighted with the quality and how they turned out. But then I opened the box. AL sees the quarter inch of room and absolutely flips out. AL, is this an effing joke? Me, I'm sorry? AL, I've ordered with you before. There's never been this much room in the box. I paid for 500 business cards, not 400. Now, I printed these cards myself. I very specifically remember that I printed 54 pages of 10, and only 2 pages were messed up, so there were 520 cards in the box. Also, I've never seen her or recognized her name. So, we've got a classic case of I come here all the time. Me, ma'am, I can assure you there's 500 cards in this box. AL, huh, I don't believe you. Me, I promise you, I'd never short a customer of cards. AL, oh, you promise me? Then why don't you count them to make sure? I want exactly 500 cards in this box, not even one less. Me, exactly 500? AL, exactly 500. Me, okay? Well, I'm sure you can guess what happened next. I stood in front of her, spreading the cards out on the counter and counting them aloud one by one. I stacked them in stacks of 20 for clarity's sake. AL, of course, stood over me the entire time. An eternity later, we hit 500, and of course, there were 20 left in my hand. Me, alright ma'am, sorry for all the trouble. Thank you for counting with me. I'm glad we could make sure your order was exactly 500 cards. I moved to put the rest of the cards in the trash. AL began to stutter. Her argument was crumbling to pieces right in front of her eyes. It was beautiful. AL, what do you think you're doing with those? Those are my cards. Me, no ma'am, you made it clear your order was exactly 500 cards, not a single one less. Looks like we messed up your order and put 20 extra in there. Sorry about that. I'll just be getting rid of these for you. AL. Well, that can't be possible. There was room in the box. You must have counted wrong. Me. Well, I am a humanities major, so math isn't really my strong suit. You're free to check my work. For now, I'll keep these cards back here. I put the 20 cards on my counter and watched as she feverishly recounted her cards. Exactly 500 yet again. She slipped out of the store without making eye contact while I was with another customer. Glad I could fix her order for her. And the last story is, you sure you want to see the manager? I work at a local restaurant as a waitress. This kid, probably 20 years old, comes in and says he filled out an application. We were pretty busy and it was very obvious. Full outdoor patio was filled and it was 2 p.m. in the summer in a touristy town. I had some downtime since my tables are all good and I tell him I can give it to a manager. He says he wants to see the manager, introduce himself, and give him the application in person. As I'm about to explain that we're kinda busy at the moment, and it would be better for him to either come back during the week, or a less busy time, or to just let me put it on his desk, a coworker comes up and hugs the kid. They apparently went to high school together. He explains he wants to apply, and asks to see the manager. My coworker says that she's a little busy, but it was good to see him, they should catch up, etc. The kid then turns to me, and says he can wait for me to get the manager. I finally ask if he's sure, and that he may be a little busy. He says he doesn't mind waiting until he's not busy, but then folds his arms and takes a Karen stance of I'm waiting. I then quickly walk throughout the restaurant trying to find the manager. Some of my coworkers in the kitchen kinda annoyed since they're very busy and didn't want to be bothered by me asking, have you seen manager's name? I finally find the manager in the back of the kitchen, helping cut onions and other fixins. He sometimes works in the kitchen when they need help and are understaffed. I can see he's very busy. He has a giant bowl next to him, full of uncut tomatoes, onions, etc. I approach him and the conversation goes like this. Me. Hey, manager's name? There's someone with an application who wants to see a manager. Manager. Tell him to leave it on other manager's name's desk. Me. He said he wants to deliver it in person. And yes, I used air quotes. Manager. Fine then. The manager stops what he's doing and is obviously very annoyed. He comes out of the kitchen and heads towards the front and the kid is still there. Side note, the manager can be a bit intimidating, especially when he's stressed, but he's the best. Shout out to you, manager. The manager also looks very annoyed, and he's walking very fast towards the front, still wearing his dirty apron and gloves. The manager takes off one of his gloves, shakes the kid's hand, the kid introduces himself, and I go back to check on my tables. About a few minutes later, I come back towards the host stand to see if any of my coworkers need help. I hear the kid talking about his work ethic, previous job experience, how he enjoyed the food at this restaurant, how he knew some of the servers there already, etc. The manager finally interrupts him and says, okay, thanks for dropping this off, I gotta get back to the kitchen now. The kid thanks him and the kid leaves. The manager takes one look at the application and then turns to me and says, this kid's name is never effing getting hired here. Comes here and feels the effing need to interrupt us on a nice day during lunch rush? Effing idiot. The manager then tears the application in half, then quarters, and then a few more times, and throws it out. He rolls his eyes and walks back to the kitchen. The coworker who knew this kid is also standing near me and sees the whole thing. I turn to her and tell her that her friend isn't getting hired. She shrugs and chuckles and goes back to what she was doing. Surprisingly, this happened again this past weekend, but I wasn't there to see, which is what made me think of this story. Moral of the story, don't bother managers when their place of business is obviously very busy, and you want to impress them. Thank you for watching. Bye.